It always surprises me that there's always different groups that we run across who are like, yeah, we want to work with you, or we want you to come on a tour or something like that. Much more than like any other rapper that I know of, at least. I mean, that's a very unique, cool thing that he's kind of created for himself with his image and style. You know, it's not, we're not going to probably have, I don't know, you know, I'm trying to remember that group, Maroon, what's that group, Maroon 5?
Ring five.
Yeah, like they did a track with Keith. For one of the members of the side group, and they did a track with them recently.
Wow.
But and they're probably not going to be calling Big Daddy Kane, I don't think. I don't
No.
think they're not really probably even familiar with him. Those kind of artists, you know.
Sure.
And then we did a tour last month with a group called The Faint. I don't know if you've heard of them.
Sounds familiar, yeah.
They're sort of like electro rock.
Yeah, sounds familiar, yeah.
That's the best description. They're from Omaha, Nebraska. Been around for I think about 10 years. Most of their releases are sort of independent, but they've created a pretty good fan base. They tour Europe a bit, and they had a pretty medium-sized tour. We did some of the dates with them, and I was just talking to the guys. I was like, "How do you guys even know about?" You know, most of them, it's Dr. Octagon, I think. Not all of them, but then the singer Todd I was talking to, and he's like, "Yeah, you know, back in the MTV Raps era, I caught some of that stuff, and I kind of knew who Keith was, Electromagnetic, and then I heard Dr. Octagon, and then I went back and got all the other, you know, stuff that I could find, and Sex Style, and everything else." So, yeah, so it's, I mean. It's kind of interesting to see the eclectic different types of artists that our fans or want to do some kind of, you know, session work.
It's good.
Yeah.
Think
It's, I think it's unusual for the average,
a rapper.
or not even just for rappers in general.
Definitely. Well, rap seems to be getting more and more dangerous, doesn't it? If you look at internet, it's like who's chasing who, who's calling who, what?
Yeah, I mean, the underground has just been driven further and further underground, if that's the term. I guess I'm just adopt that term. I don't agree with it,
No.
but and then the ironic thing is that the gangster stuff that's supposed to be hard is actually pop, which is the ironic aspect of it to me, because like. When I think of pop, I think of, you know, like the Britney Spears type of.
But the world is gangster now, so, and gangster's been dominating the rap scene for quite some time
Yeah, I
through
mean,
the
on a broader
mainstream.
scale, I mean, you know, broader sense, the world is gangster too, in
That's
the
it.
political and
You're right.
socio-economical standpoints as well, but. Hopefully things can shift around a little bit. I think, you know, things have their time. I think the one thing, I mean, like, I was sort of saying, well, the artists from the 80s, the hip hop artists, and the 90s, the golden age, so to speak, I think there may be a time where their careers are not quite as illustrious, so to speak. But I think there will be a resurgence as well.
Yeah,
I think
sure.
there has been for some artists, but I think even more so. I think, you know, there's going to be 50 and 60-year-old guys doing gigs, doing hip hop shows. Just like I think jazz went through a few phases of that. I mean, most of the classic guys, if you go see them, they're in their 60s and 70s now, right?
Yeah, I mean, even the most, I mean, still the extreme ones, they also had in a career, not just the straight, you know, straight jazz players, the more unusual ones. I mean, I think, you know, you'll see Chuck D's 50,
Right,
right?
that makes
So
sense. Yeah,
he'll
he's
be,
already 50.
yeah, he's already 50. So
Yeah,
you're already kind of there. In 10 years, he's 60, and I'm sure he'll be touring still.
Exactly.
What about, how was it to make the new album? How did you go about, from the ground up to working on that? Did you have some concept that you really wanted to use, or did you just say, okay, I'm gonna jump in this
Well,
with both feet?
I think basically it was a mood, a feeling that I kind of went off of for Dr. Doom. It was pretty much the same mood and feeling of the first album, but brought up to date,
Yeah.
using some similar sounds. I think I started there and then let it kind of grow. And it went a couple of different directions, but it's all more or less starting from that feeling, like that
Yeah.
vibe of that dark,
Energy.
sinister, haunted, thematic kind of vibe. And then, you can make, I think I made probably like three or four pretty much in that exact vibe, and then I branched off and, made variations of the same.
Expand on things.
Yeah.
So there's not
So
too much the same as the album before, because people have already have that and they say, well, it sounds the same. You'd have been stuck, wouldn't you?
yeah, I think I kind of took the feeling of that initially on a few of the maybe three songs, and then expanded and hopefully like brought it up to date more in the more modern aspect of the same production
Yeah.
stop, but just with newer, updated kind of things.
Yeah.
So I think it's fairly similar. I mean, personally, I like it better. I should like it better.
Yeah.
I've had most people say they like it better that I do. So, like the first album had what I considered maybe three or four songs that didn't even need to be on there. So I had like some filler or just songs that weren't really, didn't really fit. So I think it's the first album had like 18 songs, maybe this one has 14 or something.
Yeah.
I think Linkin Park was the most, like sales wise, and the Beastie Boys is probably the most cool. I mean, I'm open to doing that kind of stuff. I think that I'm not necessarily, what would you say? I'm not represented by anyone who's in that mix of people. So if those groups did want me, I don't think they know who to call. So I need to work on that a little bit.
Yeah.
I mean, I have an open mind about stuff. If it's something that I think I can do something with,
Yeah.
that's going to be cool. I mean, then I'm going to take a stab at it. Like, I think with the Linkin Park remix, when that happened, it was right when their album was just starting to catch a buzz, and I didn't really know who they were.
Yeah.
And I got their album, and I listened to their album, because they said, yeah, we want you to do a remix, pick whatever song you want to do a remix
Right.
to. And I listened to it, and I was listening in a sense of like, okay, which song can I take and do something to? And the song, in the end, I said, this is a song I think I can do something cool to. And I said, oh, really? That's going to be the next single off the album.
Okay.
I was like, all right, so I guess I'm on point with this. So, I mean, I think it's a case-by-case scenario.